Hey guys, so here I have my regular Photoshop open. So I'm going to go to Help, Update. So here we have this major update includes extensive improvements to the object selection tool. Now go ahead and click on the Update button. And here just click on the Continue button. Now the first problem you might run into is this window saying can't update Photoshop. This one is simple to fix. All you have to do is close currently open Photoshop. So I'm going to go ahead and close Photoshop window and go back and press the Update Now button. This should take about 2 to 3 minutes. I'm going to speed up this video. Once we get to 100%, you'll see Photoshop here under Updated Recently. So go ahead and click on this Open button over here. Now, the newly updated Photoshop will open, and you will see this small ad for the Generative Fill tool, which is the new AI tool that allows you to replace any part of your picture with a text-based AI prompt. So here they select part of the image and simply type a lighthouse. Clicking on the Generate button will insert a lighthouse at that position and also give you 3 different variations of the lighthouse. Now, the problem here you might run into is that when you make a selection here on your image, the Generative Fill tool might not be showing up. So you select a part of your image, but here you have basic selection tools, which are new to the beta. But the Generative Fill is still missing. You can look for it anywhere. You're just not going to find it. So if Generative Fill is not showing up, go ahead and go back to the Help and go to Update again. What you need to do is click on this Check for Updates button over here. Now, you might not see anything new happening, but so what you should now do is go to Beta Apps button over here on the sidebar. And this is where you will see your Photoshop beta with Generative Fill tool enabled. So just go ahead and click on the Install button, close the currently opened Photoshop application. It's going to take some time to install, so I'm going to speed up the video. Once the installation is completed, go ahead and click on the Open button. And so this is the version of Photoshop that actually has Generative Fill. So here's the preview, and they have this example showing how you can remove the tire marks and add the yellow road lines to an existing picture. Now I'm going to go back to my own image and select the sky here. So I'm going to select the lasso tool, make a selection in the sky. As soon as you do that, here you'll see your Generative Fill button. So go ahead and click on that. And in this quick example, I'm just going to type one large bird. And then click the Generate button. Now, several seconds later, we're going to get these 3 variations of the large bird. And you can use the left and right arrow buttons here to browse the 3 different examples that were generated. Now, you'll notice that in 3 different examples, the sky is still seamless. Now, I'm going to select another area of the image, and in the AI text prompt, I'm going to press Generative Fill and type distant tower. Now, I'm going to click on the Generate button. And in just a few moments, Photoshop will create 3 different versions of distant tower placed in this position here. So here again, I'm going to use left and right arrows to browse through different versions of the tower. And pretty much this is how the new Generative Fill tool works in Photoshop.